Dog team coming in!
Find them, boys!
It's not every day that a cameraman spots the bad guy before a military working dog does. But today was the exception.
Hey, we're there, right, 3 o'clock.
Individual on the one line, come out, identify yourself, do it now!
Meet Staff Sergeant Beatty and his dog, Sharon. They're a military working dog team racing through a 3-mile course as part of a friendly canine competition between Ramstein and Spengdahlem.
The competition's designed to stress your military working dog team and to an environment that you'd see downrange. Right off the bat, he went straight into a scout, as we like to call that. There's maybe a personnel, a bad guy, an adversary that could be out in a wood line that we may need to challenge and our dog needs to find. So we send our dog out there and we rely on the dog's nose to go out in the wood line and find that suspect. Once the dog finds the suspect, depending on if the personnel is compliant or non-compliant, it's determination of the handler whether to release that dog or not. In the certain scenario I was given, I had to release my dog. My dog went, bit the personnel. I got the dog off him and escorted him out of the wood line.
Sir, at this time, I'll escort you out of the wood line. If you make any sudden aggressive movements, my dog's trained to attack on or off leash with or without command. You understand?
Yes.
Go that way. Move. Guard. Leave it. Guard.
Straight into that goes straight into detection, which is our bread and butter in the military working dog section. It was a roadway clearance, which is common to what we do downrange in Afghanistan. Objective was to clear out the roadway to ensure that a convoy coming through would be clear and safe from explosives.
Okay. Leave it and trail. Call him back.
Our dog gives us subtle cues that it might be smelling odor. We call this change of behavior. It's our job as military working dog handlers to watch our dog and to know our dog's change of behavior.
Change.
We may be able to mark that area and get that dog out because there might be narcotics or explosives over in that area. And then you pressed on to multiple different scenarios, such as building searches, looking for suspects in a building.
Watch him. Good. Guard. Guard.
And then we finish up with a mass odor. A lot of times our military working dogs encounter explosives or narcotics in bulk. We want to see how our working dog reacts towards the mass odor. And then the final scenario, you're put into a vet scenario.
The dog is with me, and I'm also going
to
have.
There may be a situation where we may not have medical personnel or vet personnel to respond with us, so it's priority for the military working dog handler to be able to assess the dog and stabilize the dog until medical care can be given to the military working dog.
But what's a competition without some unexpected obstacles?
We faced problems while out on the course. Equipment went down.
Easy, easy, easy.
Leashes got tangled up. Potholes, mudded areas. And there was times that we've almost tripped. But we couldn't stop. In combat environment, you cannot stop.
Despite all of the challenges faced, Sergeant Beatty and Sharon still pulled out a win because they just kept going and going and going. At least Sergeant Beatty did. They say every dog has his day. Well, today, Sharon has to share that glory with his partner, Airman First Class Austin Siegel, Ramstein Air Base, Germany.